Services, welcome to IDENT. If you are an aviator or aviation enthusiastic, you are considered to like and subscribe. Before move on this video, make sure you have enough knowledge about VOR navigation, NTP navigation, ILS navigation with DME. I am going to be split this video into two sections. First, right now you see this on short briefing and apply this instrument short into flight simulator and flying on that. Okay. This is one of the instrument shot we used to call DME ARC approach for landing on runway 07 of Chennai International Airport, which is located on east coast of southern India. There are many instrument procedures for arrival, but what is DME ARC approach? First, what do you mean by DME? DME means distance measuring equipment. It's a radio navigation technology that measures that slat range between an aircraft and a ground station by timing the propagation delay of radio signals in the frequency band between 960 and 1215 MHz. This DME, combined with navigation equipments like VOR, ILS, NDB, like that. But based on this chart, we will get distance by Mike Victor VOR and from ILS of runway 07. But special thing about this DME ARC approach that help you to maintain constant distance around that navigation aid and airport until you align on the final course for landing on runway 07. Okay, whether you approaching from north, south, east or west for landing, by using this method called turn 10 and twist 10 in course and heading selector on the instrument panel in the cockpit. We are going to be take it as an example based on this chart. Our aircraft position, okay, 14 nautical mile distance and inbound radial 034 from Mike Victor VOR. Okay, we are going to be initially make a 80 degree right turn to enter 12 DME distance from Mike Victor VOR. Okay, and then maintain altitude 4000 by making turn 10 and twist turn until we are reaching leading radial 260. Okay, and then we are going to be maintain altitude 4000 until crossing radial 317 from Mike Victor VOR, then descend to altitude 2300. Okay, once we cross the leading radial 260, then make a left turn to established localizer runway 07. This is what it's all about. Okay, so now we are going to be apply this DME ARC procedure into flight simulator. Let's do that. Okay, now we are on the simulator. I think it's a Boeing 737 2D panel on the Microsoft Flight Simulator. Okay, so now we're going to be do that DME ARC approach based on that chart. Okay, so based on the chart, we are on the radial 034. Okay, inbound radial 034. Okay, but the track is 214. Okay, because inbound means the opposite track we are flying. I hope you people know the basics. If I say outbound 034 means aircraft track of travel also 034. So now we are based on inbound track. So that's why it's a 214. Okay, for example, if I say fly inbound radial 090. That means we are flying 270 degree. Okay, so based on the given situation, we are establishing radial 034 from Mike Victor VOR. Okay, so I want to tune that frequency. So Chennai VOR frequency is 122.50. Okay, I'm going to be tuned to this frequency on the navigation panel, and decimal 50. Okay, and also I choose that ILS frequency here 110.30. Okay. All right, now we can see this straight magenta line almost aligned on the center. So that means it tells we are on the radial 034 what we are selected. Okay, and also you can notice we are on 14 DME distance from that Mike Victor. We are on radial 034. Okay, so if you remember, based on the chart, we are on the 4000 feet, okay, on the radial 034 with the distance 14 DME distance. Okay, so what I say, I'm going to be start this DME by making right 80 degree turn, okay, and then enter on 12 DME fixed from the Mike Victor view, or then later we're going to be do turn 10, twist 10 alternatively. Okay, until we are reaching that leading radial 260. Okay, in middle, when we are going to be cross radial 318, I need to be descend to 2300 feet. Okay, so that keep in mind. Now let's start this simulator. Okay, everything's going good. Okay, now I already align on 034. Now I need to be turned 024. Okay, 10 degrees I need to be turned. Each 10 degree I going to be captured by the localizer. When I capture on the localizer on center line, I going to be turned left 10 degrees till crossing radial 260. Okay. All right. Okay, now we can see this magenta line come to straight. Then I need to be turned left 284. Turn 284. I need to be turned the course 014. If a selected course on established, I need to be turn left based on this chart. Based on this chart, we are all making left turn. Okay. All right. Okay, now we can see we are maintaining 12 DME distance. Now it's time to turn 274. Turn to 004. Now it's time to turn 264. Then make it 354. Always, when we are established on the selected course, each 10 degrees, once I establish, I need to be turned left based on this DME arc approach. turn 254. Three, four, four. As far going good, we all maintaining 12 DMA distance arc. Two, four, four, then 334. One thing remember, when you're crossing radial 317, okay, once it established on 317, we need to be descend 2300. We need to be leave 4000 to descend 2300. Two, three, four. Okay, now it's almost time to descend. Okay. Two to four, 314, descend to 2300. Okay, the first segment is completed. Now we are proceeding to 2300. My next aim is I need to be focused on when we are crossing radial 260 from Mike Victor View Wall. That's the time to turn left to establish on runway 07. Okay, now 214. Okay, we're maintaining roughly 12 nautical mile. Sometimes that we can exceed more than 1 nautical mile or 2 nautical mile based on the wind component is pushing from the left or right. We need to be maintain that, but based on this current situation the wind is calm, so that's fine, there is no problem. Okay, next 204, then 294. Now we are almost reaching the leading radial 260. Okay, once established on 260 radial, it's a time to turn left to established so to establish localizer for runway 07. Turn 274. The next 260. This is my target. Remember, once you start establish radial 260, I need to be switch VOR frequency to ILS frequency. Okay, so I'm going to be pause this simulator. I need to tune that radio. Okay, now pause here. Now we are currently navigated by VOR. Now I need to turn towards the runway, so I need to be tuned runway frequency for runway 07 Chennai is 110.30. okay, and course will be 071. I need to tune 071. Okay, now I got guidance. Okay, the ILS is a thing which give you both the vertical and lateral guidance towards the runway. Okay, so based on that we can see this magenta diamond. Okay, if it is tells, it's actually on the top based on the reference line. So technically we are low. Okay, we are on below the glide slope. Okay, so if you see this magenta line here, it's giving the horizontal information. If you see on the right side, actually you are on the left side of the runway. Okay, if it's going to be stored aligned in center, you are actually aligned on the runway. Okay, so based on that, we are the left side of the runway, we are below the glide slope. Okay, now let's continue. So time to turn left to established on the localizer runway 07. Okay, already we are established on the localizer because I press this approach button on the plane, turn automatically line up on the runway for landing. You can see the runway over there. For me, runway inside. So I'm going to be do some basic checklist. Okay, before landing checklist. Okay, now we are captured on the glide slope, runway also inside. So before landing checklist. Landing gear down, three green lights, flaps set 30, speed brakes on, landing lights on before landing checklist is completed. Okay, so now I'm going to be disengage this autopilot and land the plane manually. Once the runway inside, okay, the pilot in command can manually land the plane. Okay, that's a safe. My controls. To 1000. Okay, we are stabilized. Auto throttle disengaged. Reversal. Sixty knots. Manual brakes. Stop. Usually we are not going to stop on the runway. We need to be exit to enter on taxiway. Okay, just a simulator. Okay, I pause this simulator. Now it's time to check the flight review. So based on the chart, how close is it? Okay. Okay, all right. So this is where we are. Okay, on the radial 034 from Mike Victor Vivo R on 14 DME fix. So I initially made right turn 80 degree, then joined on 12 DME arc. Okay, so this is what we did based on the chart. Can finally landed on the runway. So this is where the leading radial. Okay, once I capture the leading radial 260 from Mike interview or it's a time to turn towards the runway. Okay, with a course of 07. From here, as of for here, I got navigated by VOR. Once I going to be turned towards the runway, I switch to ILS. Then proceed for landing. So this is what the DME ARC approach. There are many procedures there. This is a video just for rough understanding. Okay. That's it, guys. We'll see you on next video. Thanks for watching.